What is going on, everyone? It's Justin here, and welcome to another episode of Setup Makeover. And in 2020, we've really tried to focus on this makeover series, and for the most part, we've just been doing desks. But today, we have a living room makeover that is sponsored by LG and their 86-inch NanoCell TV, which, as you can probably tell, takes up the entire wall behind me. Today's setup is Trevor and his girlfriend Taylor's setup, where we're gonna take a small TV and kind of a large wall with a ton of space in the living room and make it into something that is kind of worthy of its size in terms of the real estate that we have to work with. I think the place has really nice lighting and the floor has a warm tone to it, and we're just gonna change up all the furniture, the tech side of things, put a nice TV stand in, and just keep it very simple. So let's just go ahead and get started. If you guys want to win something from this video, just make sure you subscribe to the channel, follow me over on Instagram at justin.tse, leave a like on this video, and drop a comment down below with your Instagram username, and let me know what your favorite TV show is in the comments as well. I'll be announcing a winner in the comment section when this video hits 6,000 likes, and all the products are going to be linked down below as well.
Hi, my name's Trevor. I've been working with Justin for the past year. So this is Taylor's setup here. The TV was gifted to her from her friend Owen, the couch is her roommate's, and the coffee table was picked up at the side of the street. The couch is olive green, but we have a white cover over it because the green matches nothing. We got a wood coffee table, and then there's like a clothing dresser that's holding up a 30-inch TV, which is about the same size as Justin's monitor. So what we're looking for in a new setup is a nicer couch that's a little wider, that doesn't have the cushions sliding out from under our asses as we watch TV. A new coffee table that's a little more modern looking would be nice. And then a TV, we'd like a bit of an upgrade in size and quality. And we'll see if we can decorate it pretty well with either a lamp or a nice coffee table or something along those lines.
We have a small TV, small couch, so the couch has to be pretty close to the TV. We don't have a working remote for the TV or all the cords for the Wii. Yeah, it needs to be more modern. We have a lot of clutter, Polaroids on the table, boxes and shoes everywhere.
So the first step, as always, is to take a look at the existing setup and just take everything out and figure out where we can start from scratch, paint the walls, and bring some of the new stuff in. I know a lot of the setups we've done in the past were much dirtier and messier, and in this case it was a pretty organized living room. It just needed some of the mix and match of furniture moved away so we can really start from scratch. The TV was moved away, we shifted the stand to the side, also moved over the shoe shelf because it seems to draw too much attention on the main wall, and went to the paint store to decide which color paint was the best idea because the floors had a nice warm tone so you didn't want to pull it too far away. The pink color that we ended up going with is Ocean Cruise from Cloverdale, and it is kind of in between a green and blue look, but quite subtle as well. It leans further towards the green spectrum as well, but with the natural light it looks like blue in some situations, and I just want to ensure that it didn't pull too far away from the orange on the floor. So after painting the wall, it was time to put together some of the furniture, starting with the TV stand. And this is definitely an area that we had a lot of troubles with. IKEA was having a lot of issues with inventory, and a lot of the units that we were looking for were just not available, and Wayfair seemed to have that same problem as well. So usually when you're looking for a TV stand, it's no problem to try to find something for a 55 or 65 inch TV, but in this case, it's an 86 inch diagonal, which is about 6 foot across, and it weighs over 100 pounds. So the TV stand we went with is the Samso from Loft Design, and they're having a promotion right now where if you purchase a stand, it comes with free lights that are either the white or RGB. There's definitely quite a bit to the assembly, but it was a very durable stand that looks great. It is white, very simple, and it also comes in a few different colors as well. The next step was to flip it over and figure out where we want to put it before moving the TV over and setting that in place. With the 86 inch TV especially being so large and taking up a huge portion of the wall, you kind of want that to be the center of attention. The Samsung TV stand was a good option in terms of size and durability, whether you have a small or larger TV, and I think at the price point of under $600, it is a great value, especially with the free lights. So when it came to some of the other furniture pieces, we actually picked it up from Facebook Marketplace and were able to find things way cheaper than they would have been. This right here is the Herman Miller Noguchi inspired table, and it's actually made by Article, and we got it for about 275 Canadian compared to the 800s I've been seeing. The couch is the IKEA Maraba, which I've actually wanted for quite a few years but just haven't had the right space to put it. Just a plain and simple leather, and you may have seen it in Unbox Therapy set, but it came in at a price of $400 on Facebook Marketplace compared to $900 on IKEA. So now that we've got everything else set up, it is time to take a look at the center of attention, which is the LG NanoCell 90 86-inch TV. And I just can't tell you guys enough how big this TV is in person. I think the video just doesn't do justice of it. You definitely want two people to lift this, so we just went ahead and put it on the stand, plugged it in and had it set up. And as you can see, it actually fits the room size quite nicely. So when it came to deciding what to put in the rest of the wall, there was kind of two directions. It was either moving the shoe shelf back, as well as the IKEA cabinet to give you like a large console unit, but instead we decided to have the TV front and center and nothing really else to distract the eye. The plant was a good touch of green to fill up the open space, but with kind of the spacing on each side of the TV stand, it makes the room feel bigger even with a large presence of the TV. When it comes to the TV's abilities and sheer size though, Trevor and Taylor watch a lot of things that really take advantage of something like this. Whether it is the Netflix shows that are in 4K resolution or Dolby Atmos and Dolby Audio support, playing a lot of games on the Xbox as well as the next generation consoles that are coming out soon, or most importantly sports, which can include watching hockey, football, or in my case would be Formula One. As you guys might know, I'm putting together my office loft at the moment, which has enough space to have a TV of this size, and I definitely look forward to possibly adding one to that space. So now we're going to talk about the TV, and this is LG's new series for 2020, which is the Nano 90, and they make it in sizes from 55 inches all the way to 86, which is the one that we have behind me, and this is the biggest TV that I've seen in a setup in person. And I can tell you it is massive, and in the past couple years, TV prices have really come down to more of a reasonable state. 86-inch TV a couple years ago would have been five figures easily, and many of them still cost over $10,000, but this right here is a TV that comes in at a price point under $3,000 in the US, and in Canada it is still under $5,000. The first thing that I definitely noticed when looking at it in this living room is just how stylish it is. For an 86-inch TV, it is very thin, the bezels are small, and the stand is also quite minimal, so if you don't want to wall mount it or if you're not allowed to in a rented place, then it can really fit into any space. In terms of actual visual traits though, this is a real 4K TV, and there are many features that really future-proof it in terms of the content that you can watch today and also content that will be more readily available down the road. So I think the first question that a lot of people are going to have is what exactly is a NanoCell? You hear that name around a lot with LG's lineup that has been around for many years now. So it's actually a 1 nanometer particle that absorbs a lot of the unwanted light wavelengths to enhance the purity of RGB colors, or in simpler terms, dull colors. This essentially gives you a nice vibrant TV viewing experience, and paired with the full array local dimming with precise backlight control, it also gives you deeper blacks and enhanced contrast edge to edge. The first set of optimizations are on the Dolby side, including Dolby Vision IQ and Dolby Atmos. What IQ does is adaptive ambient light adjustment based on your current room setting. And Dolby Atmos is the well-known audio experience that gives you multi-dimensional sound, and from what I notice, a lot of Netflix shows already support this. The next set of optimizations come in the HDR10 support, and there's actually quite a bit of content that is currently available in HDR, including YouTube. Depending on what you choose to watch, you also have a lot of different modes, including Vivid, Standard, APS, Cinema, Sports, Game, HDR Effect, and a special one called Filmmaker Mode in caps. This encourages you to enjoy the visual experience of a movie exactly the way that it was filmed. The gaming side of things are also very important, and as someone who uses the game mode specifically with a console, and I'm surprised to find that a lot of people don't, I notice a huge difference in the input lag improvements. There's also AMD FreeSync built in, which automatically adjusts the refresh rate of the TV to match the source, so if you want to connect your PC and game through this large TV, you can definitely do so. Aside from some of the Netflix shows that are very well optimized to take advantage of the features on the TV, Trevor also loves to watch a lot of sports that are fast-paced, including hockey and football. With a combined experience of vibrant colors and good contrast, as well as the fast refresh rate, I think this is the perfect combination to be versatile in the content that you plan to watch.
With a TV of this size, quality is also a lot of times something of question. And with over 8.3 million pixels, I can tell you this TV looks very sharp, and you don't want to sit too close to an 86-inch TV, but from the distance that we have here, which I would say is a pretty comfortable distance, the TV looks amazing. Of course, pretty much every TV set now has smart capabilities, and this right here has LG's interface that includes Netflix, Disney+, Amazon Prime, and YouTube.
The remote itself also has everything you need to control and navigate your menus and channels, and being a smart TV, having quick access buttons is also great. With a scroll wheel and the wand design to quickly navigate the large surface area, that also makes things much faster. But I think the bottom line is, if you want an 86-inch TV and you have the space for it, you have one right here that is very attainable in terms of the price point. It is definitely not cheap by any means, and I know smaller TVs have really dropped down in price. But here you've got a TV that has all the latest and greatest technology that you can expect in 2020 in a price point that I feel like is really reasonable for what it's able to offer. If you guys want to check it out for yourself, I'm going to drop a link down below, and a huge thanks to LG for sponsoring this video. So going into the details on the other areas of decor, we added a plant with kind of a brown basket that goes very well with the floors, and you can find these at like Home Outfitters or Bed Bath & Beyond. I think if you have a flat wall and the space to do it, then a plant really brings in a bit of life to a very technological heavy space. The Noguchi table being glass and wood goes very well with the floors, but the glass piece especially allows the room to still feel very large. The only thing to keep in mind though is with a TV of this size so close to it, it does reflect quite a bit at night. Overall, I can definitely see why there are so many Noguchi-inspired options available on the market. They're definitely coming back, and we've seen a lot of them on Facebook Marketplace, and in some cases, I've even bought some just to resell. If you ever need to like move it around or get it out of the way, it is also relatively easy because the wood stand on the bottom folds up. This couch overall is a very good value, and it seems to hold up quite nicely. And for a couch that looks like this, you can definitely see a large range in terms of price, so I feel like $400 on Facebook Marketplace was a great deal. When it comes to the shoe shelf, I thought about adding one of those ladder shelves from IKEA, but unfortunately we're not allowed to drill into the wall in some situations. But a simple shelf like this can hold many more pairs of shoes, as you guys probably see, and just be able to display them and its colors, which almost serve as decor if you are a huge shoe collector. One thing that I really like about this TV stand though is how you're able to present your consoles in the middle. You've got a lot of storage on both sides and in the middle, but by having your Xbox or PS4 there, it actually looks pretty cool. As for the bar cart on the side, it just felt a little bit bare, so we thought we'd just put something there that has a bit of glass, some color to it, a couple shoe boxes that didn't fit on the shelf. And to fill in the other side, the lamp was like a good accent, but in terms of how much it's actually used or turned on, that really depends. To fill in the side next to the couch, I also added a love backen from IKEA, which is just like a small side table that has a nice wood grain to it, and it's just a good place to put a drink or a controller. But now that we've completed this makeover and talked about it, let's go ahead and get Trevor and Taylor's reaction before wrapping up the video.
I really like how the wall color turned out. I was really worried when we saw it on the paint can because it looked super green, but I feel it adds a lot of personality to the room. My favorite part of the living room is probably the coffee table. It looks super modern and it goes really well with the couch. I like the plant in the basket and I like that it's fake, so there's no maintenance needed or anything. The couch is from IKEA. I really like that it's black and leather opposed to our just cloth one before that was white. The black also adds a lot more modernness to the room.
I really like the LG TV. The size is obviously pretty crazy. I did not expect anything that big. It fills the room nicely. We can watch from a little further back than we usually would on the old 40-inch TV. And the TV stand looks really good too. It was hard to find one that would fit such a big TV, but I like how simple it is. I like the lights within it and the little sections where I can put my Xbox or whatever Taylor needs to store. Yeah, PS4. Other than that, yeah, I'm really happy with how it turned out, and I really couldn't have thought of it any better myself.
I like how the shoe shelf was still incorporated with the living room, but I like that it isn't like the main attraction. It's kind of just off to the side, so once you come in, you see it.
The bar cart was a nice little addition as well. Right now we just have some books on it and some drinks and stuff. It could also be for snacks or whatever, but I feel like it's really good, especially for if we want to entertain or anything like that. So that was kind of a cool little addition.
So this setup is now complete, and although we kept it very simple on the main wall, I think when you have a TV of this size, you don't really have to put anything else there. You've got a plant on this side, and also just a lamp over there. The shoe wall is moved over here, and you just got like a simple couch that is in the middle with a side table, and also a table that looks like the Herman Miller Noguchi that we picked off You guys have seen me do living room videos in the past, and I think the one thing that is in common of all of them is that they all have large TVs, but nothing even close to 86 inches. And for some reason, my own places always have like a fireplace or no room for a large TV setup. So being able to like check out some sports and just watch some TV shows and whatever, the TV stand is also super simple. And when we're trying to look for a TV stand that can support a TV of the size and weight, there really was only a few options that were readily available, and I think this one looks pretty good. It was between this and the IKEA, but for the price point and the color options that are available and like the slot in the middle for a console or your TV setup, I think this is definitely one that we can recommend. Although the TV already looks incredible in the daytime, I think it looks even better at night when everything is just blacked out and you have a TV of this size that is just committed to giving you the best visual quality possible. It really brings out the colors and contrast and presents a TV in its best state. So if you're watching like a movie, a TV show, or a sports game, you may want to fine tune some of the settings for evening use so it isn't too bright, but I can tell you it looks super good and I'm trying my best to show you over video. But otherwise, thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Setup Makeover, and please let me know in the comment section down below as to whether we should do more living rooms or stick to desks. As always, if you enjoyed this episode, please subscribe to the channel and drop a like on this video, and I'll see you all in the next one.